Mtazamaji, ni Jumanne ya tarehe 2 mwezi Julai mwaka 2024. Wakati mwingine tunakongamana hapa mtazamaji kwenye kipindi cha Tamrini, ambapo siku ya leo maandamano ya kizazi cha vijana inatarajiwa pia kuonekana ama inafanyika katika maeneo tofauti hapa, na kama tulivyokuahidi tuko nayo wanahabari wetu wamekita kambi katika maeneo tofauti ili kukuletea tu taarifa amba na kadi tu inapochipuka. Na hapo baadaye mtazamaji tutakuwa tukizungumzia tu baadhi ya masuala ambayo tu sisi kama nchi tunapaswa kuyazingatia sana kuhusiana na mustakabali wa taifa. Tutakuwa tunalidadafua masuala kadha sekta tofauti ikiwemo sekta ya kilimo. Lakini kabla ya hayo mtazamaji, nataka useme nasi pia kwenye mtandao wetu wa kijamii, kurasa wa Facebook ni @KBC Channel 1, kule Twitter ni @KBC Channel 1, na sasa kama unavyoona kwenye runinga yako na katika maeneo ya Kangemi, kama unavyoona mtazamaji, hali ni vivyo hivyo, taswira kamili ya jinsi maandamano ya inayoendeshwa na kizazi cha vijana. Na sasa tunaungana na mwenzetu Abdulaziz Hashim ambaye yuko katika maeneo ya Kangemi, atupatie taswira kamili ya jinsi shughuli inaendelea katika maeneo ya Kangemi. Kwako Abdulaziz.
Shukran za dhati mwenzangu Khalid Abdullahi kutoka upande huo wa studio. Niweza kuzungumza na lugha ya kimombo. Seeing on your TV screen is where the police officers have been able to launch a tear gas. Two of them to be exact, you can see them. Those are live images here in Kangemi along Wayakiwe. You can see even cars are turning back. This has been the situation for the last 20 minutes or so, where the police were able to engage with the protesters around this particular area to push them back. These were some of the protesters who were trying to go to town and join their brethren who are currently within the central business district to continue with their peaceful picketing. But as you can see, the police has cordoned off this particular area and ensuring they go back. This has been the situation for the last 10 minutes or so. Khalid, we can also inform you that we got here about 20 minutes. The situation was palatable. It changed drastically. The protesters came out of nowhere, actually, even caught the police by surprise, but the contingent was prepared for such a scenario and they were able to contend. Earlier on, right now, the bonfire they had lit, it has been at least it has been put off by the police officers and some of the residents who were helping. And along this particular road also, there were many places cutting off transport. Vehicles were able to turn back, especially, you know, this is the route that is applying to many parts of the country, to Naivasha, Nakuru, Eldoret, and many other parts of the country in that side of the Rift Valley. This is the main nerve where residents are able to go to many other parts of the country. If my cameraman can focus, you can see right now those are protesters who are trying to regroup after they were pushed back by police officers using tear gas canisters. This has been a cat and mouse game, so to say, because that has been situated. You can see again, there you have it. Those are live images. You can see again, the police have been able to launch a tear gas canisters who are present there. And along this particular road, also, do not mistake those are not firearm gunshots. Those are tear gas canisters that are being launched in that area. The police are trying to push them back. As you can see, they're lobbing from down here all the way to where the protesters are congregating. The police are unable to enter because, you know, Kangemi, it is a slum, and the police cannot venture inside this slum area due to security concerns. You can see even some of the protesters are trying to pelt stones at the police officers. Some of the residents here are trying to access their homes because they are back from work. They are trying to access some of their houses, given that some of them reside in this particular area. The police are trying to quell this particular situation because, as I told you, this is a very critical road connecting not just Nairobi, but many other parts of the Rift Valley part of the country. There you have it again, a tear gas canisters, as the protesters continue to launch, or rather pelting stones at the police officers. You can see the bunch of the youth, they continue with their chants on the right side as the police continue to launch their tear gas canister. Just look at this particular police officer holding a tear gas canister. They're about to launch more side, because the youth have started to pelt stones. Even some of the residents, especially mothers, are coming this way. They're saying they cannot enter, and there you have it again, lobbing towards them. But what we have seen also is once those tear gas canisters are lobbed towards those protesters, they relaunch it back to where the police officers are. This was not the situation earlier on. When we got here 20 minutes ago, it was a little bit better, but it drastically changed. But the police officers were also prepared for that particular scenario. Right now, the contingent in civilian clothes as well as the anti-riot are here to just ensure they're able to quell the demonstrators from making their way inside the city. It's a long distance from Kangemi all the way to the Central Business District, because they'll have to pass through Westlands. First of all, ABC Place, and then Westlands, and then through the capital, through the University Way, and make their way there. As you can see, the police have been able to push them back. Right now, they have occupied areas. They don't make their way there due to security reasons. What the paramount security contingent are trying to protect here, major roads, and some of the civilians who are using this particular road to make their way. But as I told you, right now, this people are coming back from town to enter their normal area of residency, which is Kangemi and many other parts of the country. Canister has been launched towards the protesters, because they are trying to ensure they do not regroup, because they are pelting stones towards the police officers. And luckily, at least us as journalists and many media houses, we are behind the police officers. So we are a little bit safe in the area we are right now. As you can see, that particular route the police officers are launching those tear gas canisters is where those youths are trying to escape through. And they are trying to regroup as well, with the police officers also urging members of the public, for their safety, to go home or to go to any area of residency where they will feel safe. Continue camping here to give you these live images in Kangemi. This is a very important road connecting to the capital as well as to many other parts in the country, especially the Rift Valley part of the country, Naivasha, Nakuru. But the police officers are stationed here. Even the matatu operators have been unable through this particular road. We have seen a bunch of motorcycles going this way. But for the operators, as you can see, they even alighted at this particular stage where we are behind you. You're unable to see that because we're focusing on where the images are, but behind us the matatu operators are alighting those passengers so that they can walk towards the area of residency, because they fear their cars could be damaged. As I told you, the demonstrators have been able to use stones. They are pelting stones at the police officers and some of the cars that are passing through the road. Even ahead, you know the infamous bridge in Kangemi, you can see they've already lit another bonfire on that particular area just to vent their frustrations. But this road has been cordoned off. They're continuing with pelting tear gas, lobbing tear gas canisters, rather, I should say, in that particular area. But we'll leave you with this live images of Kangemi. As we're speaking to you, these are live pictures coming to you to Kangemi. More tear gas canisters have been lobbed as the protesters continue to regroup there, where they have lit a bonfire, and some are escaping through various corners through this particular area. Matatus are being turned back, and the residents are being urged to walk towards their various houses. But as you can see, on the right side, where there is a bridge, that is where the youths are converging. But Khalid, we'll try and bring you this live images as we continue to camp here. But for now, I need to hand you over back so that my colleagues in other parts of the CBD can tell you what is happening. These are live images from Kangemi.
Naam, shukran sana Abdi Aziz Hashim. Huyo ni mwanahabari mwenza ambaye anatuletea tu picha za moja kwa moja na kutupatia tu taswira kamili ya jinsi swali ama shughuli nzima ya maandamano hiyo inaendelea katika maeneo ya Kangemi. Ametupatia tu mambo kadha wa kadha akisema kuwa kizazi cha vijana wameonekana kuandamana, lakini polisi wameonekana kuwa ange ili kutawanya waandamanaji, huku kama tunavyoona picha hizo za moja kwa moja ni polisi ambao wamekita kambi katika maeneo hayo ili kudumisha usalama na waandamanaji kutofika katika maeneo ambalo wanataka kuingia. Kama alivyosema mwenzetu Abdi Aziz, amesema hiyo ni katika maeneo ya Kangemi na pia barabara ya Waiyaki, na waandamanaji wametokea lakini wanasema wamesitishwa na maafisa wa polisi. Amesema madakika 30 20 hivi zilizopita, amesema mambo haikuwa hivi, mambo ilikuwa imetulia, lakini sasa hivi tunaona kuwa maafisa wa polisi wanatupa vitoa machozi ili kuwatawanya waandamanaji. Ni swala ambalo mtazamaji natuleta kwenye mada yetu kwa siku ya leo kuhusiana na mustakbali wa taifa. Kumbuka hapo baadaye pia tutakuwa wenye kupeleka katika kaunti tofauti, kule kaunti ya Mombasa pia tutakuwa tunakupeleka kupatia tu taswira kamili ama picha za moja kwa moja masuala ambayo yanaelekea katika yanayoendelea katika maeneo hayo. Lakini mtazamaji, nataka ni mkaribishe mgeni wangu.